Hello everyone, this is Dr. Kailash Chetchan. So in continuation with the instrumental methods of analysis, today we will discuss about theory, instrumentation and applications of conductometry. Conductometry is one of the instrumental methods of analysis which is based on the measurements of conductance value. So we know that the conductance value is nothing but the ability of the solution to conduct electric current. It depends on the number of ions present in the solution, that is concentration of the solution. It depends on mobility of the ions or solutions. Means if the mobility of the ions is very high, then conductance value will be higher. If it is less, conductance will be lesser. The charge carried by the ions and temperature of the solution. For a given solution, at given temperature, conductance of the solution varies directly with the number of ions. That is, the conductance value depends directly on concentration of the solution. So we have different types of conductance like equivalent conductance, molar conductance and specific conductance. Equivalent conductance is nothing but the conductance of a solution which contains 1 gram equivalent weight of the electrolyte. And molar conductance is the conductance of the solution which contains 1 gram molecular weight of the electrolyte. Whereas specific conductance of the solution is the conductance of an electrolytic solution kept between 2 electrodes of cross-sectional area 1 centimeter square and they are kept 1 centimeter apart. Thus, specific conductance is the conductance of 1 centimeter cube of the solution. Like all the metallic conductors, electrolytic solutions, they also obey Ohm's law. So Ohm's law is nothing but E is equals to IR, where E is the applied potential, I is current, and R is resistance offered to the flow of current. We know that a resistance of any conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor, and it is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. That is, R is proportional to length upon area. So which can also be written as R is equals to rho L by A, where this rho is specific resistance. Now we know that conductance is nothing but reciprocal of resistance. Therefore, C is equals to, we can write it as 1 by R, where C is conductance and R is resistance. So thus, we can write C is equals to 1 upon rho dot A by L, which is nothing but C is equals to a constant kappa, which is known as specific conductance multiplied by A by L. So when area of cross-sectional is 1 and length is 1 centimeter, then conductance is equals to specific conductance. Coming to the instrumentation, that is how a typical conductometer looks like, or what are the basic components of conductometer. So it contains a conductivity meter, which is used to measure the conductance value of the solution. Then it contains a conductivity cell. This is the conductivity cell. The conductivity cell is made up of 2 platinum electrodes placed at 1 centimeter apart, and they are having cross-sectional area 1 centimeter square. And these platinum electrodes, they respond to the change in the concentration of the analyte. The change in concentration of the analyte will be detected by these platinum electrodes, and correspondingly the change in conductance value will be displayed on the conductivity meter. Then one microburette will be there, in which standard solution of titrant will be taken, and then a container in which a solution, analyte solution, will be taken. And as the burette is added continuously, the analyte solution will be stirred by using a stirrer. So what are the applications of conductometer? The conductometric measurements are used to determine the end point of acid-base titrations. So normally the acid-base titrations, we are going to find out the equivalence point by the volumetric titrations. So in which we are going to find out the end point by knowing the change in color. If the color change is not identified properly, then we may get error in finding out the equivalent point of the solution. If equivalence point is not determined properly, then concentration will be different. Therefore, to get more accurate readings, we are using this conductometric method of analysis. So here I have taken the examples of acid-base titrations involving strong acid and strong base, weak acid with a strong base, and a mixture of strong acid and weak acid with a strong base. Strong acid with a strong base. This is strong acid, I have taken it as HCl. Strong base, I have taken it as NaOH. So HCl and NaOH react to give NaCl and H2O. So as we know, the conductance value depends upon mobility of the ions. So initially, HCl, which is taken in a container or a beaker, when it undergoes dissociation, it forms H plus and Cl minus ions. The mobility of H plus ions is very, very high. Therefore, initially, the conductance value will be higher. So as NaOH is added from the burette, these H plus ions, they are replaced by Na plus ions, whose mobility is less. Therefore, the conductance value goes on decreasing. When this HCl is completely neutralized, then the excess amount of NaOH which is added because of more OH minus ions, whose mobility is again little bit higher than Na plus ions. Therefore, the conductance value goes on increasing again. And to find out the end point of this conductometric titration, we have to plot the graph of volume of titrant added or NaOH added in this particular example against the conductance value. The point of intersection, what we get here, it will give us the equivalence point of the titration. Once we get the equivalence point, simple mathematical calculations will give us the concentration of HCl present in the solution. Another application I have taken here is weak acid with a strong base. Weak acid, acetic acid, strong base, NaOH, which react to form sodium acetate with the liberation, with the formation of H2O. Sodium acetate is the salt formed here. So as this is a weak acid, it dissociates partially. So initially the H plus ions will be very less. So therefore conductance value will be lesser. As you go on adding NaOH from the burette, sodium acetate is produced. Sodium acetate is highly ionic in nature, and as a result, a gradual increase in the conductance value takes place. After the complete neutralization of this acetic acid, again due to excess addition of NaOH, due to more OH minus ions, conductance rapidly increases. When you plot the graph of conductance versus volume of NaOH, so this point of intersection will give us the equivalence point of the titration. So one more example, mixture of strong acid and weak acid with a strong base. So in the container or in the beaker, there is a mixture of HCl and acetic acid. And you have to find out how much amount of HCl is there and how much amount of acetic acid is there in the given acid mixture by titrating against an AOH solution with the help of conductometer. We know that in a mixture of strong acid and weak acid, as long as strong acid is there, the dissociation of weak acid will be stopped. Therefore, first HCl undergoes dissociation to form H plus and Cl minus ions, and as the mobility of H plus ions is very high, initially there will be a very high conductance value. So as NaOH is added from the burette, H plus ions are replaced by Na plus ions, which are less mobile in nature. Therefore, the conductance value goes on decreasing. After the neutralization of this HCl, now the dissociation of acetic acid will start to take place. It dissociates and reacts with NaOH to form sodium acetate salt. And the sodium acetate salt, which is highly ionic in nature, because of the formation of that salt, gradual increase in the conductance value take place. After the neutralization of acetic acid, again due to more NaOH addition, because of more OH minus ions, once again the conductance increases rapidly. And when you plot the graph of conductance versus volume of NaOH, the first point of intersection will give us the volume of NaOH required to neutralize HCl. And in between the second and first intersection points, this much volume of NaOH is required to neutralize acetic acid. So by these equivalence points, when you go for the calculation, you will come to know how much amount of HCl and how much amount of acetic acid is there in the acid mixture. So these are the applications of conductometric titrations. Thank you. Do subscribe this channel for more videos related to chemistry.